Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to create your own custom exceptions, also known as user-defined exceptions. There is a previous video called Exception Handling in this playlist, so make sure you've seen that one before moving on to this video. And at the end of this video, we're going to be creating a project where we will verify somebody's age for some sort of like fake membership. And if they are under a certain age, then what happens is that our custom exception will be thrown. So that's it. Let's get started. Before you reach the end of this video, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe so that we together can challenge and defeat the mighty YouTube algorithm. Hey, welcome back everyone. So for this video, I'm going to teach you guys how to create your own custom exceptions, also known as user-defined exceptions. So there's a video in this playlist called Exception Handling, or something like that. So you'll want to be sure to watch that before you watch this video. So just as a reminder, an exception is an event after execution that disrupts the normal flow of a program. So a few examples we've covered in the past were arithmetic exceptions, if somebody divides by zero, for instance, or an array index out of bounds exception, and then file not found exception if we're working with files and we can't locate a file. So we can create our own custom exceptions that can handle something very specific for our programs. So a few ideas that I thought of were maybe like a duplicate email exception. If somebody's signing up for an account and they're registering with an email and we do a database query and then that email already exists, we can create a duplicate email exception to let the user know that that email already exists. Or maybe if somebody's paying with a credit card and they enter in invalid information, we could create an exception called invalid credit exception. I'm just making these names up, by the way. They're not actually exceptions, but they're descriptive of what they can do. And then one that we'll be working on for this project is age exception, where maybe if somebody's signing up for a membership or something online, and if they're under a certain age, we can throw a age exception, and that'll let the user know that, hey, you're not old enough to sign up for this membership. So that's just a few examples of custom exceptions that we can make. There's all tons of different exceptions that you could do for very specific situations. So let's get started. What we're going to do is to create a new class. So if you're using Eclipse, go to File, New, and then Class. And then we will call this the name of whatever exception we want. So I'm just going to call this age exception, and then we'll click finish. Now you're going to want your custom exception class to extends the exception class. So this exception class is going to be the parent class for the child age exception or whatever else you called this class. So we're going to set up the constructor for age exception. So we're going to type in age exception, parentheses, and we're actually going to set up a parameter, maybe a string, and we'll call this message. So if this exception is thrown, we're actually going to display a message such as you're not old enough to sign up for this membership or something like that. So within the constructor for your age exception class or whatever else you called this, you're going to call the super constructor class. So super, and then we're going to send a message to here to actually take care of this message. And that's it. That's all we have to do for this class. So just a quick summary of what we did here. This age exception class, if this exception is thrown, we're going to pass a message that says something like, you are not old enough to sign up. And we're immediately going to take this message that's passed in and send it to the super constructor for the exception class, and that's going to handle exceptions like it normally would. So that's all that this class does. We're going to do everything else within our main class then. So let's accept some user input. Let's set up a scanner, and we're going to ask the user for what their age is. So we'll set up a scanner first. We'll just say scanner, and we'll call the scan equals new scanner system.in. And then we'll need to import something, so make sure you have this import, and then we'll create a prompt, and we will have the user enter their age. So enter your age. And we'll place this within a variable, and we'll call this age. So int age equals scan.nextInt. Okay, the next step, we're actually going to create a method to check our age. So we'll call this method checkAge, and we're going to pass in the age variable. So with this checkAge, we're going to surround this with a try block. And we're going to catch exception E. And then we'll just print out a message. So system.out.println A problem occurred. And then it's going to list what exception was thrown. So we'll just say plus E, which is the exception object. Now we need to create a method called checkAge so it actually does something. Now outside of your main method, we're going to create another method. So this is going to be a static method. It's void, it won't return anything. And it's called checkAge. And it's going to have one parameter set up. It's going to accept an integer and we'll call it age. Now we're going to have this method throws age exception. And then we need a set of curly braces. Now with our checkAge method that throws age exception, we're going to list the condition which will throw a new age exception. So what we'll check is that if age is less than 18, then we're going to throw new age exception. So if age is less than 18, what we're going to do is throw new, then the name of the exception here, so age exception in this case. And then we'll pass in a message because we have it set up so this accepts a message as a parameter. So maybe we'll add a new line character plus a message such as you must be 18 or older to sign up. So if they're not less than 18, they're either 18 or greater than. So maybe we'll put an else statement that says system.out.println, you are now signed up. And that's it. Let's run this. Enter your age. Let's say that I'm 18 years old. So that's the minimum requirement. And it says you are now signed up. So since we used this checkAge method, and our age was not less than 18, we used this else statement and no exception was thrown then. Now let's try it again. So enter your age. Let's say that we're 12 years old trying to sign up. And it says a problem occurred and it lists the exception that we have, the age exception that we made. And you can see that it occurs here. It just does a print line of a problem occurred and it displays the exception object. And here it throws the new age exception and it displays our custom message that we want to display to the user where it says you must be 18 or older to sign up. So that's basically custom exceptions, also known as user defined exceptions. So you'll create a custom exception for something specific in your own program and then you'll probably want to have a custom method that will throw that specific exception. And within your method that throws that custom exception, what you'll do is usually list some sort of criteria or condition where that exception is thrown or not thrown, depending on how you want to write your program. But yeah, that's the basics of user-defined exceptions. So if you would like a copy of all this code, I'll post it in the comments down below. And your assignment is to create a method that throws some sort of custom exception you made, and then post it in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of user-defined exceptions in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.